Comedian Pete Davidson has made quite a name for himself, but in his path to stardom on Saturday Night Live and the big screen, he's had to overcome many obstacles, like mental health issues and the loss of his father. This is his tragic real-life story. One of the biggest tragedies in Pete Davidson's life happened when he was only 7 years old. During the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001, his firefighter father Scott lost his life while rescuing people trapped at the Marriott World Trade Center Hotel. After he made his way into the building, the tower where the hotel was located soon collapsed after it was hit by the second hijacked plane. Losing his father at such a young age was extremely traumatic for Davidson, who sought help from mental health professionals. Scott Davidson reportedly had a terrific sense of humor, just like his son. He was only 33 years old when he died that day. In 2014, Pete memorialized his dad by tweeting, "Can't believe it's been 13 years. Feels like it was just yesterday. Words can't express how much I miss you."
He's a very good dude, and I have a lot of jokes about it, and if you don't like the first one, you probably won't like the rest.
After losing his father, Davidson found it tough to confront his demons and deal with everything he was going through. While growing up, he was prone to releasing his emotions in unusual ways. As his mother Amy told the New York Times in 2015, it was sad how sad he was growing up. One time in school, Davidson pulled out all his hair in frustration, and as he told the Times, in many ways he became a, quote, "lab rat for physicians who are trying to understand the experiences of the children of victims of the terror attacks." As he told the Times, it was overwhelming. Davidson wasn't spared by his classmates as he experienced bullying from them. In a 2016 interview with radio DJ Peter Rosenberg, he revealed that he had just one friend whom he could trust in high school, while many other kids weren't very nice to him. As he put it, "I was in school having a rough time grieving, so I was acting out a little bit. I didn't have any friends." Davidson was drawn to comedy from a young age. In fact, he was still a teenager when he performed for the first time. At the age of 16, he took to the stage at the Looney Bin Comedy Club in his native Staten Island. He was a little awkward and a bit unsure of himself, but he nevertheless went ahead and put on an impressive act, delivering the most unusual lines without batting an eyelid. For example, he cracked a joke about being attracted to cougars with the punchline, "I think 21-year-olds are so hot." His act back then is a lot like his act now, as he prefers to just be himself. As he explained to The Ringer in 2020, "I don't know how to act or write characters or do impressions." For Davidson, comedy clubs felt like a safe haven where he could finally blend in and feel at ease. It also helped that he had the support of his mom, who would take him to his stand-up gigs. As she told the New York Times in 2015, "He had a tough time growing up without a dad. I wanted him to be happy, and this made him really, really happy." Ever since his teenage years, Davidson has been battling a chronic illness. He was first diagnosed with Crohn's disease when he was around 17 or 18, but he's learned to live with it. He received medical assistance and whatever he needed from his doctors, but the only thing that seemed to work for him was marijuana. In a 2016 interview with High Times, he revealed, "My stomach would just be in pain all day and I wouldn't be able to eat. And then I'd smoke. I'd be able to eat and be able to do my shows."
"I wouldn't be able to do SNL if I didn't smoke weed. I wouldn't be able to do anything, really."
Crohn's disease is a chronic ailment that can result in inflammation of the gastrointestinal tract. Symptoms include such unpleasant experiences as constipation, cramps, diarrhea, and rectal bleeding. Despite living with Crohn's for years, Davidson hasn't let the illness bring him down, and he's also had the support of his loved ones. When he got bullied for dark circles under his eyes, which can be a symptom of Crohn's, his then-girlfriend Ariana Grande shot back at haters by tweeting, "You all do know this man has an autoimmune disease, right?" While marijuana has helped Davidson deal with his medical troubles, it's also had a negative impact, as he found himself becoming addicted to the point that he's had to check himself into rehab. He's never shied away from speaking about this particular aspect of his journey. In 2017, he opened up about beating addiction by writing on Instagram, "I quit drugs and I'm happy and sober for the first time in 8 years. It wasn't easy, but I got a great girl, great friends, and I consider myself a lucky man." Davidson has also been open about this part of his life while performing on SNL. During an appearance on Weekend Update, December 2019, he quipped, "I'm going on a little vacation. You know, the kind of vacation where insurance pays for some of it and they take your phone and shoelaces, and you have roommates, but it still costs like $100,000.
I hope you know, Pete, that a lot of people really care about you."
Yeah, sure.
And in addition to helping Davidson with his drug use, rehab also proved to be beneficial for his mental health. In addition to all his other struggles, Davidson is also living with borderline personality disorder, a mental illness that manifests in a pattern of unstable relationships, a distorted sense of oneself, and a tendency towards strong emotional reactions. He was diagnosed with BPD in 2017. Around that time, he took to Instagram to write at length about how his behavior led to others lashing out at him. As he put it, "I've been getting online bullied and in public by people for 9 months. I've spoken about BPD and being suicidal publicly only in the hopes that it will help bring awareness and help kids like myself who don't want to be on this earth. I just want you guys to know." He added, No matter how hard the internet or anyone tries to make me kill myself, I won't. I'm upset I even have to say this. To all those holding me down and seeing this for what it is, I see you and I love you. Mental health experts praise Davidson for choosing to go public with his diagnosis. For example, Sophie Lazarus, an assistant professor of psychiatry at Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center, noted that it could go a long way in helping to take away the stigma attached to the illness. As she told Today, someone who thinks they are untreatable or overly emotional or damaged might see this and look up what the symptoms are and seek treatment. When it comes to Pete Davidson's love life, things have been rocky to say the least. He was dating Ariana Grande for a little while, and they hit it off so well that they even ended up getting engaged in June 2018. But it didn't work out, as they split up in October of that year. As a source close to Grande told People magazine, "It was way too much too soon. It's not shocking to anyone." Davidson was majorly impacted by the breakup, and he even deleted his social media accounts in the wake of the split. The timing was especially difficult, as about a month earlier, Grande's ex-boyfriend Mac Miller had passed away from a drug overdose. Before his relationship with Grande, Davidson was linked from 2016 to 2018 to Cassie David, daughter of comedian Larry David. He began dating Grande just days after the breakup. In Cassie's 2020 essay collection, No One Asked for This, she revealed that when she found out that Davidson had decided to conceal his tattoos that were dedicated to her after they broke up, she felt distraught and worried. As she described it, "I felt like I was being terrorized." In 2020, it was rumored that Davidson was in a relationship with model Kaya Gerber, although they ultimately ended up splitting as well. In December 2018, soon after his breakup with Ariana Grande, Davidson scared his family and friends when he took to Instagram to share a message that was highly unsettling. As he wrote, "I really don't want to be on this earth anymore. I'm doing my best to stay here for you, but I actually don't know how much longer I can last. All I've ever tried to do was help people. Just remember I told you so." After posting this message, Davidson deleted his account, but plenty of people were quick to react. The New York Police Department went to check in on him and made sure that he was safe. His message received comments from fans offering him support. Unfortunately, a few were less than supportive, as they encouraged him to take his own life. But he also received support from famous friends, with rapper Kid Cudi tweeting, "Thinking about you, Pete. Hit me back, bro." Thankfully, nothing irreversibly tragic happened, and he actually appeared on Saturday Night Live later that day. This may have been the most public case of Davidson struggling with thoughts about killing himself, but it wasn't the first. As he revealed in a 2018 interview with Variety, he once tried to drown himself in a pool when he was in the fourth or fifth grade. Davidson has a significant number of tattoos, and they've served as a sort of therapy for him. He's used them to reclaim his voice, express himself, and cover up the scars he has from self-harm, as he would often hurt himself by cutting to deal with his emotions. During a 2020 interview with Charlamagne Tha God, he discussed how he knew that he needed to get professional help. He revealed that he knows things are going south when he ends up cutting himself and things feel a little too unbearable, or even when his loved ones come up to him and say something like, "Hey, we're all like worried, so you should go get help." Davidson also noted that he has a good circle of friends and loved ones who care about him and his mental health. One of his tattoos serves as a tribute to family, as his left arm bears the digits 8418, which were his father's firefighter badge number. One of the most surprising and sad revelations is that Pete Davidson has felt bullied during his time on Saturday Night Live. In his 2020 interview with Charlamagne Tha God, he got candid by confessing that he hasn't always been fully aware of what was happening on the show. He explained that while he felt extremely excited about the gig at first, he realized that he was eventually often being targeted in the jokes and some of the sketches. As he put it, "I have a weird feeling in that building where I don't know whose team they're playing for, really. If I'm the joke or I'm in on the joke.
I don't think I'm very well perceived, I don't think."
Indeed, there have been multiple SNL sketches in which Davidson has been playing parts that are less than flattering or a little too close for comfort. There's the dim bulb Chad, and then there are all the times on Weekend Update when he's opened up about morbid and private details of his own life. Essentially, Davidson wasn't sure whether he was really being respected on the show, and he's even considered leaving the cast for good. As he put it, "If I'm just fodder now, though, maybe I just shouldn't be there. They think I'm f***ing dumb. Like, I'm literally painted out to be this big dumb idiot." If you or anyone you know is having suicidal thoughts, please call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK-8255.